It's your boy Soda bringing you another GTA guide. Today we're going to be looking at the nightclub in GTA Online, why you should buy one, and how it works.
And by the time you are 28 years old, you have so much money you can't even count it. What do? You make your dreams come true.
Ice cream, bring that ice, boy. Walking, oh, that's high. Yeah, they can't tell me why.
So how it works is you open up your phone. You go to money and services, you go to Mace Foreclosure Bank, and it's the disc icon over here. As you guys see, I'm clicking through different locations. Different locations will be different prices. I just bought this one over here personally because my motorcycle club is right. I know my yeah, my motorcycle club is right here and my arcade is right here. So everything is relatively close to each other, and I would buy the nightclub, which is closest to your other businesses and your motorcycle club. And anyways, when you buy one, this is what you should do. The style is up to you. Every different style is going to cost a different amount of money. That's the one that I personally wanted. You also have the light rigs that if you want. I personally like that one the most, so I bought that. You can also choose between different nightclub names, as you guys see over here. Technology, I just like the neon sign, this one the most, but it's completely up to you. And then this is the important part. This is how the nightclub makes money. I mean, there's two ways on how the nightclub makes money. One is really, it's not beneficial at all, but this is where the real money comes in if you're playing GTA online. So when you go to the storage units, you're going to have five different storage facilities, right? You want to buy all five. But before you do that, make sure you have at least four motorcycle club businesses. You have a bunker, and make sure you at least have either the vehicle cargo for the CEO or the special vehicle cargo, because all of that ties into your nightclub. Both your CEO and motorcycle club MC businesses both like make money through your nightclub, and I'm going to show you guys how. And also you have the garages over here, and then you have dancers. If you wish to have dancers, you can have like two girls, two boys, and boy and a girl, and you can have different styles for them. I'm not going to really showcase that because that's not so important. Anyways, so I'm going to show you guys how to make money with the nightclub. First of all, you have popularity.
I'll cut to the chase. I ditched my friends for popularity. I literally became the Regina George of my middle school.
Increasing your popularity, you can either do nightclub missions and then, or you can change DJs, but both of those are a waste of time, so I wouldn't bother with that. The wall safe will only carry 75,000 maximum, and it takes 48 minutes. So every one day in GTA, which is 48 minutes, you can make like $10,000, but that's a baby method. It's not worth it. Don't waste your time with that because you're only going to lose money, and there's better and more productive things that you can do. But I'm going to show you guys the storage units and how that works. So you're going to want to go into your nightclub, and as you guys see over here, I have made 14 million, almost 15 million from my nightclub sales, from my warehouse earnings. As you guys see, here is all the money I've made from my wall safe, which is only 221,000. Like I said, complete waste of time.
So I can do for you, man. You know? Don't waste my motherfucking time!
Don't worry about your popularity, but here is the real money, the warehouse, and this is where the storage units like play in. As you guys see, almost 15 million. If I do the next sale, I have total stock right now 740,000. So if I sell this, I'm gonna be over 15 million by far. So this is how it works. So for every storage unit you buy, you can get one technician, right? For every business that you own. And then I believe technicians only cost 100,000. I think you get the first one for free, or the first two for free. And then after that, you have to hire another technician for 100,000. And once you hire him, you'll always have them. So it only costs around 400,000 to hire all four technicians, and it is completely worth it because then you can assign them for your different businesses over here. Like as you guys see over here, I can assign, like, let me show you how this works. So I have this guy on sporting goods, and if I had like a forgery, I could put him on printing and like copying. So you assign a technician to one of these, and these are like organic produce is my weed business, sporting goods, I can't remember what that is. South American imports is my cocaine lockup for my motorcycle club. Cargo and shipments is my special vehicle cargo, I believe, or then it's my special cargo warehouse. Pharmaceutical research is, I believe, my bunker. So that's why I said have four motorcycle club businesses and also have a bunker, as well as at least one CEO business, so that you can hire five technicians and then assign them to production. So what they do is pretty much they gather cargo for you passively. You don't have to do anything. So once you have the motorcycle club businesses and as well as the CEO business, what all you have to do is assign your technicians to acquire the goods for you, and they do this over time. So as whatever you're doing, as long as you're playing in game, these guys will be collecting cargo for you. You don't have to resupply, you don't have to buy supplies, you don't have to do anything. The only salt of my sweat on my brow. The only thing you have to do is sell the goods. And if you sell above 500,000, then all you need is a mule truck. So like right now, if I were to sell all goods, I would get 740,000. I might show this to you guys right now actually as well. So that's why you should buy like four, but you should have at least four businesses, and then like at least four motorcycle club businesses, and one bunker, and at least one CEO business before you start this up. But if you have over 75,000 worth of product, like $500,000 worth of product in your nightclub, let me show you guys what you will need. You'll need a custom mule. I believe if you have over $500,000 worth of product and you have all of the businesses I told you to get, then you're going to want to go into Warstock, Cash and Carry, and then you will want to buy this mule custom. You're going to need this to be able to deliver the cargo. And the good thing about it is you can take it to Los Santos Customs and you can upgrade it to make it go a little bit faster. But it's really not that expensive. It's only 72k, and you're going to be selling over $500,000 worth of cargo if you get it. So you're going to make that money back instantaneously. You're going to make that money like tenfold pretty much if I do the sale that I do now. And then let me show you one more thing that I forgot to explain. I will do the sale for you guys right now as well to show you what it's like. Hold up, that's the wrong laptop, my bad. Sometimes I get messed up. Two laptops, man, sometimes confusing.
Is it better than the one you have at home?
I have a chair at home.
Yeah, you have a chair.
I have a chair for myself?
Yeah.
No way.
You also have like special sales that you do, or you can do the entire sale. So let me show you what I mean by that. So when you go to sell goods, you have like these custom things that you need, right? So I need sporting goods, 8 out of 12, or 2 out of 2, or 1 out of 1, or so forth. But if I were you guys, I would do whatchamacallit. If I were you guys, I would just sell all goods. Don't worry about the special orders. If you sell special orders one by one, it's going to take you a longer amount of time. I would just play the game as you normally do, farm as you normally do, and then do the sell all goods mission. And anyways, let me show you guys this right now. And hopefully it doesn't get blown up. I mean, if it does, there's nothing you can really do about it. So I would maybe do the sale with some friends and having them help protect you, or you can do it in a solo public session. But you cannot do this, sadly, in a private session. You have to be in a public session. And like I talked about just now, I'm going to be using my mule custom. And luckily, there's only three. Sometimes you only have to drive the truck into one place. Sometimes you have to make like five deliveries. But for this one, I have to do three different deliveries. And sadly, I can't play the GTA radio because YouTube will block my video on copyright grounds, because Warner Brother Music Group owns the majority of this music in GTA. It's sad, I know. Alright, so I'm just gonna fast forward through the driving, and I'm just gonna show you guys the different drop off points. It's completely random every time you do it, so it really doesn't matter. Like, these drop off points really don't matter, but like, as you guys see, I'm using a truck. One thing before I fast forward, be careful about other players griefing you, because literally all it takes is one rocket. Alright, that is my second good drop off, and then onto the last one, and I'll be showing you guys how much money I will be making. As you guys see right now, the lobby is pretty full, so I should get a good like high end bonus or high business bonus from this. We'll see. Catch you guys at the third drop of point, dude. Are you serious, bro? I'm not even like, oh my goodness, bro. What?
Why did you take it from us?
You're clearly standing in front of us, Brick.
God damn you! Brick.
Brick is dead.
No, Brick's alive.
Brick is dead. Look at him.
He's not dead. He's not dead.
Ah, fam. We had a little bit of a ambush waiting for us. Some rival crews, you know what I'm saying? They're jealous of the amount of money we're making, man. Making Escobar moves, man. Shout out to my man Pablo. And now all I gotta do is leave the area, so I'm gonna quickly call my presser Mark II, and then we're gonna make do with that item. Perfect. And as you guys see, I made 779,000. Tony took a cut of the price, but Tony's laundry cut was 74,000, and then we got 779,000 because we were in a lobby with other people who got a little bit of a high-end bonus for that. If there was more people in the lobby, I could have made even more money. But that just goes to show you that the nightclub business is really good, and now I'm back on 49 mil and I've made over 15 million from my nightclub. So thank you guys so much for watching. That's the nightclub guide. If you like the video, please like and subscribe, and I will have more GTA content and more guides for you guys later on. Thank you so much for watching. Peace.